As in the last video, we dive deep on what happens when you go through the center of the Earth. In this video, we will then see why people say that orbit is basically something in freefall. What does that even mean? We will understand what happens when while falling, we also move horizontally. We all have studied that when you add horizontal motion while falling, you get a parabola. But that's not entirely correct. We will see why not. If this sounds interesting and you have 10 minutes to spare, let's jump in. Let's get some needed basic concepts. Have you ever been in a car when it takes a turn on high speed? You must have noticed that you feel a sort of force pulling you in the opposite direction from the turn. Even though from your frame of reference, it might look like you are getting pulled in the opposite direction. From the road's frame of reference, you are moving on a circular path. And even if you are moving with constant speed on that path, your direction is changing. And hence, the velocity is changing, which means there is an acceleration at work here. And as per Newton's laws of motion, in an inertial frame of reference, if there is an acceleration, there must be an unbalanced force. And that force must be in the direction of the acceleration. But the force you feel seems to be acting outwards. That's because of the frame of reference. Since you are in accelerated frame of reference, that is non-inertial. And the force you feel is called pseudo-force. It is not a real force. The real force is actually acting towards the center of the turn. And that's how your direction change is towards the center. And it's called centripetal force. As we have discussed in previous video, for any real force, you can ask who is applying the force. This question distinguishes between a real and a pseudo force. But that's a discussion for another day. Here in our case, that force is the friction force between the tire of the car and the road. That is providing the force so that you can have an acceleration to keep on moving on a circular path. Any guess what would happen if the friction force is not sufficient enough to move you on that path? Due to inertia, the car will want to keep moving with the same velocity, and you experience it as a skid or drift. Now that we understand the basic concept of circular motion, let's start with a very interesting fact. Why you weigh less on the equator compared to the poles of the Earth? Let's look at our Earth from the North Pole. And when you are standing on Earth's surface, since it rotates around the axis, you move on a circle. And as we understood earlier, in order for an object to move on a circular path, there must be a force acting on that object towards the center. Here, in this case, we have gravitational pull of the Earth, which pulls everything towards the Earth's center. We can now put up the question like how much force do you need to move on this circular path? I am so glad you asked. It is given by this equation. Here, Fc is the required centripetal force. Lowercase m is mass of the object. Lowercase r is the radius of the circular path. In our case, it's the same as radius of the Earth since we are standing on the equator. And omega is the angular velocity, means angle rotated per unit time, which is approximately 360 degrees per 24 hours. The Earth's gravity provides this required force which keeps you on this circular path. And that force is given by this equation. When you do the math and compare both of these forces, you will see that the Earth is pulling you with more force towards the center than you need to move on the circular path. And this difference is what you feel as your weight. Now let's move towards the poles from the equator. Let's see what are the things which remained constant. Your mass, Earth's mass, angular velocity of Earth, radius of the Earth, and of course the gravitational constant. Remember, you just walked up towards the axis on the Earth as a sphere. While Earth's radius is the same, your distance from the axis reduced. So now you are moving on a smaller circle, so smaller radius, That means the required centripetal force is smaller in this case, and hence your weight will be more. This means your weight is maximum on the pole, and as you start moving towards equator, your weight reduces and it is minimum at the equator. Your weight is nothing but the force with which you are falling down. Now, rearranging the equations on the right, you see, if you speed up the Earth's rotation, meaning increase the angular velocity omega, at some point this term will catch up with the force of gravity. And as you would have guessed, at that point the weight will become zero. And rather than standing on the ground, you will just float at the surface of the Earth. You might be wondering, what is the angular velocity or rotation frequency at which this happens? If you do the math, you reach the number of approx 90 minutes for 360 degrees. So in order for that to happen, a day should only have 90 minutes. Do you know where does that happens? In low Earth orbit. So ISS would be an example. You see, you are still falling. It's just the falling force, meaning weight is zero now. And this is what we call orbit or free fall. But how does this relate to jumping in the tunnel through the Earth? If you remember, in the last video, this is the same time it takes for you to fall into a tunnel through the Earth and oscillate back. This is because gravitational field is what we call conservative field. For now, let's understand why is this happening. In the projectile motion video, we saw how when we throw something up on an angle, it follows a parabolic path. Well, turned out that's not 100% correct. That is just an approximation. You see, here we assume that the gravity is pulling directly vertically downwards, because assuming that makes horizontal velocity constant, and math becomes easier. While this is very, very close to reality, when the projectile path is really small compared to the Earth, when the size gets comparable and you throw a projectile, it is as if you are putting horizontal motion in an object falling through the Earth. The direction of gravity is not in just one direction or downwards. Rather, it always pulls you towards the center, which means a component of it will also affect horizontal motion. And not only that, the acceleration itself also keeps changing from the frame of reference of the Earth. The math gets too complicated here and is out of the scope of this video. But this is how we get near circular path rather than a parabola. I say near circle because it's actually elliptical. If you enjoyed this video, you will really love this video here, where I talked about in-depth physics behind what happens when you fall through the Earth. Thank you so much for watching, and subscribe for more.